I worship you. I worship you.
Good morning, St. Columbus family. We welcome you to today's online Sunday service. We pray that you're well and we look forward to the blessings of the Lord that Christ has in store for us this day. But should you have any welcoming words for us even as we begin our service?
Sure. Good morning, St. Columbus family. Good morning, viewers out there. We greet you all in the loving name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. We hope to enjoy it together.
Amen and amen. Beloved in the Lord, whenever we come before the presence of the Lord, we always begin our services with a call to worship, inviting us to worship our living God. And our call to worship this morning is coming from the book of Psalm. We'll be reading from Psalm 91, verses 1 to verses 7. Psalm 91, verses 1 up to verses 7. Listen to God's word to you. Whoever dwells in the shelter of the Most High will rest in the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I trust. Surely He will save you from the fowler's snare and from the deadly pestilence. He will cover you with His feathers, and under His wings you will find refuge. His faithfulness will be your shield and rampart. You will not fear the terror of night, nor the arrow that flies by day, nor the pestilence that stalks in the darkness, nor the plague that destroys at midday. 1,000 may fall at your side, 10,000 at your right hand, but it will not come, near you. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Glory be unto the Lord. What a wonderful scripture, inviting us to worship God, but not only that, but granting us assurance that the Lord is our refuge, and that blessed are those that dwell under the shadow of the Almighty One. Glory be unto God. Friends, even as we begin our service, let's turn to God in prayer as we call upon the name of the Lord. Let us pray together. Our dear Heavenly Father, King of Glory, we thank you, God, and praise you for this morning. Thank you, God, that your Spirit is here with us and that your Spirit abideth with everybody that has tuned in into this service. We pray that, King of Glory, as we spend this time in your presence, we pray, Almighty God, may you manifest your presence, Lord. Manifest your power in our lives, O God. May each one of us be charged, rejuvenated, encouraged by your presence even during this time. Those that are feeling discouraged and hopeless because of the circumstances in their lives, we pray that, God, may you grant them a word for the season to encourage them, King of Glory. We pray, Almighty God, that you alone will begin with us the service and that you will end it with us. For we pray of all these things in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, and the Church of Christ said, Amen.
And amen.
Our glory be unto God. Our friends, at this point now, we come to that time when we sing our opening hymn, and we've got our songbird here, Patricia. She's going to lead us in our opening song for today's service. Patricia, what is our opening song for today?
We are singing from the JHS, or Above All Power.
Above All Power. Above all glory. Praise the Lord. Stay tuned, friends, even as we sing along to the glory of God.
Our opening hymn is hymn number 7 from the JHS. Let's sing together. Above all power, above all kings, above all nature and all created things, above all wisdom and all the ways of man, you were here before the world began. Above all kingdoms, above all thrones, above all wonders the world has ever known, above all wealth and treasures of the earth. There's no way to measure what you are worth. Crucified, laid behind the stone, you live to die, rejected and alone, like a rose trampled on the ground. You took the fall and thought of me. Crucified, lay behind the stone, you live to die, rejected and alone, like a rose trampled on the ground. You took the fall and thought of me, and thought of me. Glory be unto God.
Thank you, Patricia, for leading us in that wonderful hymn, chorus to the glory of God.
Amen.
Amen and amen. Friends, we've come to that time when we turn to God in prayer and ask for God's forgiveness over our lives. We all sin against God, whether knowingly or unknowingly, we sin against God. And it is only prudent that we do not become used to sinning. We should never give ourselves into our weaknesses. As children of God, we should endeavor to live that upright life that Christ has called us to live. A life that is not conformed to this world, but a life that is conformed to the kingdom of God. A life that is a blessing to the people around us and unto our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Not a life that is an enmity to the cross of Calvary, but a life that is rebellious to the word of God. And so, friends, we are at that time when we just take stock of how we've lived our lives. And even as we do introspection of how we've walked before God, may we do so with sincerity. And even as we ask for God's forgiveness, may we not ask for God's forgiveness for the sake of asking. And then right from here, we go back to our old vomit. But we pray for God's complete deliverance of our lives, that even as we live our lives, we may live our lives anew to the glory of God. Patricia is going to lead us into that moment, that time of prayer, even as we call upon the name of God. Patricia, you kindly lead us in a time of confession, please.
All right. Shall we pray? Our dear Heavenly Father, we want to say thank you for this wonderful morning that you've blessed us with. God Almighty, we want to realize that, Lord, we've sinned against you in different ways, in the way we've talked to one another, even by not doing that which is right. We ask you, God Almighty, to forgive us and to cleanse us from every unrighteousness. May you help us, O God, to continue to strive for purity. May you help us that, Father, in Jesus' name, we shall be able, O God, to be knowledgeable that you are a God of mercy, but you are also a God of wrath. Therefore, Father, may you help us that we should not treat you with contempt, but we should be able, O God, to strive for that purity all the days of our lives. May you be glorified and uplifted that, Lord, even as we continue the service, we shall be assured and know that if we've confessed with sincerity of heart, you are a wonderful God who always forgives us. May you continue to be with us through Christ Jesus, we've prayed. Amen.
And amen and amen. Thank you so much, Patricia, for that a prayer of confession. Amen. Beloved in the Lord, our God is a merciful God. He's a gracious God. He's slow to anger and full of love. He does not treat us as our sins deserve, but instead he calls us to come to him, to confess our sins unto him. And the Lord is always there to pardon us of our wrongdoings and embracing us into his kingdom. Having confessed our sins according to the Holy Scriptures of God, in faith and in humility, believe it, receive it, that the Lord has surely forgiven us our sins and cleansed us from all unrighteousness. Glory be unto God. Friends, at this point now, we turn to the time for anthems. And Patricia, what anthem are you singing for us today?
I'm singing a song that calls us back to Himself. If we've been wandering around, not accepting His grace upon our lives, asking, probably we've lived a life of wasted days, not knowing Him, He's inviting us to know Him and embrace His grace upon our lives.
Amen and amen. Amen. Thank you so much. Stay tuned.
Be blessed with the song.
Have you wandered alone on that pathway? Have you lived with a life of fear? Have you searched for grace without meaning? Or is your life with a life of wasted days? Wasted days, wasted days. Oh, how terrible. As you walk on in darkness, in fear, turn around, turn around. God is calling, He's calling you from a life of wasted days. Have you wandered alone on that pathway? Have you lived with a life of fear? Have you searched for grace without meaning? Or is your life with a life of wasted days? Wasted days, wasted days. Oh, how terrible. As you walk on in darkness, in fear, please turn around, turn around. God is calling, He's calling you from a life of wasted days. Wasted days, wasted days. Oh, how terrible. As you walk on in darkness, in fear, please turn around, turn around. God is calling, He's calling you from a life of wasted days.
Glory be unto God.
Glory be unto God for that lovely song, Patricia. Indeed, God is calling the whole world from living a life of wasted days. It's time to be serious with the things of God, I believe.
Amen.
It's time to commit ourselves more and more unto Christ, because Christ is coming, friends.
Amen.
The King is coming, and therefore let us be ready even for His coming. But we thank God for that lovely song once again.
Amen.
And now, friends, we come to that time when we listen to the word of the Lord. Let's prepare our hearts even as we turn to the word of the Lord. Stay tuned. Beloved in the Lord, we've come to that time when we turn to the Word of God and hear what the Spirit of God is saying to the church today. Our scripture reading is coming from Psalm 46. We'll read from verses 1 up to verses 11 and listen to God's Word to you. God is our refuge and strength, an ever-present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth give way and the mountains fall into the heart of the sea, though its waters roar and foam and the mountains quake with their surging. There is a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy place where the Most High dwells. God is within her. She will not fall. God will help her at her, will help her at break of day. Nations are in uproar. Kingdoms fall. He lifts His voice, the earth melts. The Lord Almighty is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. come and see what the Lord has done, the desolation he has brought on the earth. He makes woes cease to the ends of the earth. He breaks the bow and shatters the spear. He burns the shields with fire. He says, be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth. The Lord Almighty is with us. The God of Jacob is our fortress. This is the word of the Lord. Let us stand to God in prayer. Heavenly Father, King of glory, we thank you, God Almighty, that you are here with us. We pray, O Lord, that God, may you speak unto us through your word in Jesus' name. We pray, Almighty, that may you bring to our attention your word, your will, that which you want the Spirit of the living God to declare unto the church today. We pray, O God, may you make it plain unto us. Speak to us, O Lord, for your servants are ready to listen. We pray all these things in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Now, beloved in the Lord, the scripture that we've read is an interesting passage. We need to understand that this passage, beloved in the Lord, is divided in three distinct sections, beginning with the first section, verses 1 up to verses 3. Now, verses 1 to verses 3 is this particular section is looking on a fear that there is nothing to fear in life. Many of us, we have so many scenarios, so many situations that kind of arouse fear to creep into our hearts. So many scenarios and situations that make us kind of feel vulnerable, that makes us feel anxious, especially those moments and situations that seem to be so much uncertain to us that we feel we've got no control over. They sometimes have a tendency to bring or to arouse fear into our lives. Now, verses 1 to verses 3 is speaking to us that we should have nothing to fear. And there's a reason why we should have nothing to fear. The reason why you should fear nothing is because God is with us. Now, this message comes to us in a way to challenge our confidence in terms of what do we put our trust in. Many people put their trust in a number of things. Others put their trust in their parents in terms of kids. Others will put their trust in their friends. Others will put their trust in certain systems around them. But then the real question is, are those things that we put our trust in absolutely reliable? Do they assure you or warrant you of the help or the aid that you may be in need of? The psalmist, beloved in the Lord, he presents this psalm to us in a way to challenge our confidence in terms of who do we put our confidence in. And so the psalmist is bringing this word to us as a reminder that we have nothing to fear in life. Why? Because God is with us. So our assurance, beloved in the Lord, is nothing else but the very fact that God is with us. The very fact that God is with you should be enough to help you sleep at night, knowing that whatever struggles you might be going through or you might be facing, you've got a greater assurance, the best assurance that you may ever have that you pull through. And that assurance, beloved in the Lord, is the presence of the Lord in our lives. And that's why even the message for today is looking at God, our ever-present help. God, our ever-present help. That is the title of our message even for today. The second section, beloved in the Lord, is looking at the Lord as being enthroned in Jerusalem. And this, beloved in the Lord, is the basis or is the secret for the confidence that the children of Israel had. The very fact that God was enthroned in Jerusalem, that in itself, the very fact that God is enthroned was secret enough for them to grant them confidence in any situation. It didn't matter what the circumstances were dictating or what circumstances they found themselves in. The very thought that God is enthroned, the very thought that God is seated on the throne, beloved, in the Lord, was enough to give them or to assure them of confidence even through the passages of life. The third section of this psalm, beloved in the Lord, which is verses 8 to verses 11, speaks of peace on earth and world dominion. In this particular verses or section, beloved in the Lord, there is a sense of vindication that comes as a result of putting your confidence and your trust in God. There's always a vindication. There'll always be a vindication when you put your faith, your hope, and your trust in God. Somehow, the Lord will never let you down. The Lord will never fail you. The Lord will never put you to shame. There's always vindication when children of God put their trust in the Lord. And this, beloved, in the Lord was the joy of the children of Israel, bearing in mind that whatsoever situation, circumstances that surrounded him, they could rely and put their trust and their hope in the name of the Lord. Beloved in the Lord, God is our refuge. He is our refuge. The word of the Lord says, the name of the Lord is a strong tower, and the righteous run to it and they are safe. God, beloved in the Lord, is our refuge and he is our strength, our very present help in times of trouble or in times of need. Blessed are those that realize this truth and put their trust in the very fact that the Lord is with them. May you realize that your safety, O child of God, may you realize that your protection, O child of God, is not in riches, is not in armies, is not in the power of the horses or the chariots, is not in anything else, it is not in any individuals in your life. Your confidence to face life, O child of God, your safety, O child of God, your protection, O child of God, your victory, O child of God, is in nothing else but in the very fact that the Lord is with you. That in itself should be strong enough. That in itself should be enough for you to realize that whatever circumstances that you might ever find yourself in, the Lord is more than enough for you and for me. Beloved in the Lord, when you look at the historical background of this psalm, beloved in the Lord, the children of Israel believed in the miraculous deliverance of Jerusalem. At this particular time, they had been under siege by Assyria, who had subdued Israel. And so at this point, beloved in the Lord, things are not looking so good for Israel. But still, even in spite of the siege that had come upon Israel, Israel does not lose hope. Israel does not lose faith. They do not lose their trust in the name of the Lord. They realize that even in such time, somehow they realize that God's presence was going to come through in a unique way and bring them deliverance. And so the children of Israel relied in God's ever-present help in times of need. And so they were not moved, even in this time that they are going through. They believed that God was coming through for them. Glory be, friends, unto God. This psalm, beloved in the Lord, is a hymn of encouragement. It's a hymn of encouragement. I love every sentence within this psalm. You can read this over and over again. What a wonderful psalm that it is. It speaks, friends, about God's greatness. It speaks about God's unbroken presence in our lives, that God is not like man who comes in and goes. All our relationships that we have in our lives, friends, they are temporal. There's none of our relationship that is consistent. There's none of our relationship that will remain unbroken. All our relationships with all those people within our lives, there will come a time, and there comes a time when that relationship breaks, whether it is by death, or maybe you just go separate ways. But somehow our relationships, our physical relationships, there comes a time when there is a breaking within those relationships. But when it comes to God, beloved in the Lord, glory be unto God, that our relationship with our God, friends, has no any brokenness in it, beloved in the Lord. There will never be any breaking within this relationship that we have with our God. It is a straight line. It is consistent, meaning it is real. It is true. It is reliable, because it does not break at any one point. It is consistent. God's presence, beloved in the Lord, in our lives is always consistent, beloved in the Lord. Glory be unto God. And so, as such, the psalmist, beloved in the Lord, he saw God's presence in his own life and in the lives of his compatriots to be that which is infinity, that which is forever, that which is everlasting, beloved in the Lord. And that in itself was confidence enough for the psalmist to face life with all the confidence that he needed, knowing that God was always going to be even in his life. This assurance, beloved in the Lord, did a number of things in the life of the psalmist. It gave him boldness not to fear in life, beloved in the Lord. It gave him the boldness not to worry about the storms of life and those worrisome moments that we life may present along our way. It gave him that boldness, beloved in the Lord, not to fear, not to worry about all these storms of that you might meet in life. We see, beloved in the Lord, in the psalmist's words, I like these words. Even when the earth gives way and the mountain falls, verses 2, the waters roar and the mountains quake with their surging, he told himself, beloved in the Lord, I will not fear. Let me read that again. Let me start from verses 1 up to verses 3. God is my refuge and strength, an everlasting help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth give way and the mountains fall into the heart of the sea, though its waters roar and foam and the mountains quake with their surging. He says, we will not fear, beloved in the Lord. What a lovely, lovely reflection, beloved in the Lord. Why does he not fear? Because amidst the confusion of life, amidst the blurriness of life, the psalmist goes on to say, there's a river. Verses 4, there's a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy place where the Most High dwells. And so, beloved in the Lord, he does not fear of anything. Why? Because there's a river right in the heart of Jerusalem. There's no river in the heart of Jerusalem, but the psalmist, beloved in the Lord, he sees this spiritual river that signifies the presence of the Lord. Beloved in the Lord, when you are by the streams of living waters, you can just reflect in terms of the calmness, in terms of what that scenery brings unto an individual. And so the psalmist is saying, even though all these things happen unto Jerusalem, there is a spiritual river that the enemy might not see, but there is a spiritual river, and that river is the presence of God. And so whatsoever is happening, there will still be a calmness in the lives of God's children. Even when the earth quakes, there will still be a calmness, because there is a river that is greater than whatever is happening around, that brings a certain stillness and calmness to the soul of these believers, beloved in the Lord. And so the psalmist says, even when all these things happen, he says, there is a river, beloved in the Lord, the river whose streams Make glad the city of God, the holy place where the Most High dwells, beloved in the Lord. Beloved in the Lord, when we put our hope in God, when we put our trust in God, there will always be a certain calmness, a certain joy. That's why the Apostle Paul writes to the church at Philippi in Philippians 4. He says, rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say rejoice. And he writes, and he says, he's saying these words of jubilation and rejoicing. Meanwhile, he's in prison. So, in short, beloved in the Lord, it does not matter the circumstances around us. When we put our hope and our trust in God, God gives us the confidence to face life. Even as we are passing through this corona situation, a pandemic that we are in, beloved in the Lord, may your soul not be moved. May your heart not be moved. May we put our trust, our confidence in the name of the Lord. For we serve a God who makes a way even where there seems to be no way. We serve a God who's able to shut up the mouths of lions so that the children, so that his servants are protected, like it happened even in the case of Daniel. He's able to keep the flames from burning the children of God. Why? Because he loves us, beloved in the Lord. And so even as we reflect on this word, beloved in the Lord, may we be reminded and encouraged, beloved in the Lord, that the Lord presence is ever with us. And so the psalmist, beloved in the Lord, he puts his trust in the name of the Lord. He sees this spiritual river whose tributaries or streams go back and forth through the city, watering the city, bringing nourishment and encouragement to the city, so that what, even though the city is going through a number of challenges, through war and siege, somehow there is no panic, beloved in the Lord. Why? Because there is the presence of the Lord within the city. Glory be unto God. Beloved in the Lord, the psalmist, he says in that city of God, amongst the people of God, God, he sees God in their midst. He sees God in their midst. And he pushes further to say, because God is present with his people will not fall, says the psalmist. Why? Because God will help them through. God will help them through at daybreak. He will help them through at daybreak. You know, at daybreak, some people say that it is darkest, you know, at daybreak. And so the psalmist says, when it is darkest, the Lord will see you through. Even in our lives, beloved in the Lord, there are some situations that occur within our lives. But I submit to you, O child of God, no matter how dark it may seem around you, put your hope in God. At daybreak, beloved in the Lord, when it is darkest in your life, know that the Lord is coming through even for you. Glory be unto God. And I love how the psalmist concludes this psalm. He says, be still and know that I am God. Be still, verses 10. He says, be still and know that I am God. How we need, beloved in the Lord, to be still in our lives. There's so many things that happen in our lives, but may God help us to always remember to come to that place where we just become still in the presence of the Lord, where we become still and listen to the voice of God and hear the words of the Spirit of the living God that he's saying to the church, beloved in the Lord. May God help us. Whatever you are going through right now, I submit to you, O child of God, may you be still and know that God is with you. God is with you. Beloved in the Lord, we all go through various situations in our lives which make us feel anxious. We all go through those moments that get us so worked out, that make us feel so worried. It's normal to go through all those uneasy situations within our lives. We will go through those moments and situations and circumstances within our lives. Now, we need to understand that even when we go through those moments, the encouragement that comes to us, friends, is that do not let those circumstances, do not let those situations to speak louder than your faith in your God. Do not let any harsh circumstance, whatever difficulty you might be passing through, No matter how strenuous it might be, no matter how unsurmountable your situation or circumstance might be that you are going through, I submit to you, O child of God, do not allow that situation to speak louder than your faith in your God. Why? Because your situation, that situation you are in, O child of God, it is not permanent. It's not the conclusion of your life. It is not the full stop of your life. It's just a comma along a sentence that God will finish for you. God is the last say. God is the full stop even in your life. And so I submit to you, O child of God, that do not let that situation overwhelm you, O child of God. Why? Because God always has the final say in every situation that affects our lives, O children of God. It's not man that has a final say. It's not that situation that has a final say. It is God himself who has that final say concerning the circumstances in your life. What God frames is expecting of us is to have faith in him. Whatever situation we find ourselves in, no matter how grave that situation might be, what God expects of us is to have faith even in him. For there is nothing, friends, too difficult for the Lord. There is nothing too hard for the Lord. There is nothing that the Lord can fail to do for you, O child of God, because you are the apple of God's eye. God watches over your life, the Bible says. He even knows the number of hairs on the crown of your head. That's how intimate God is with you. Isaiah 43 says, when you go through the waters, they will not flow over you. When you pass through the fires, they will not consume you. They will not set you ablaze. Why? Because the Lord, beloved in the Lord, is ever with us. And I submit to you, a child of God, that the Lord is with you in whatever circumstances that you are passing through. Do not allow the circumstance to speak louder than your faith. Let your faith react even in those situations, because you are a son of God. You are a daughter of God. You are a child of God. Never forget who you are. Sometimes just look at that situation, address that situation, and identify yourself as a child of God, because you are a child of God. And the Lord will not allow harm to befall you, because he is your ever-present help. Glory be unto God. When you find yourself in that hard place, between a rock and that hard place, sometimes your faith will be tested, O child of God. But it is that time that you need to allow your faith to react. Remember who you are. Remember the promises of God. You remember that you are the child of the Most High God. You remember that you belong to the kingdom of God. Remember who you are and who God says you are, O child of God. May God help us, beloved in the Lord, that in whatsoever situations we find ourselves in, let faith react by trusting in God, call upon his name, and believe in God's deliverance and salvation upon your life. Many people, beloved in the Lord, when they pass through shadows of affliction in life, when they pass through hurdles in life, they choose to complain. But God forbid that you may be found amongst those that complain. But may you be found amongst those that call upon the name of the Lord, that trust in the name of the Lord. May we, beloved in the Lord, have the wisdom, the courage, the strength, and the attitude, beloved in the Lord, that we need, that whenever we are passing through difficult times, may we not be amongst those that shrink back, beloved in the Lord, but may we be amongst those that call upon the name of the Lord. Whenever you have a challenge, O child of God, before you, may you always just put your trust in God. Put your trust in God. Blind Bartimaeus, when he needed his sight, he cried out to Jesus Christ, "Jesus, son of David, have mercy upon me." He placed his trust in the Son of God. May God help us, beloved in the Lord, that whatsoever situation you are in, no matter how grave it is, may you shout out and call upon the name of the Lord. "Jesus, son of the living God, have mercy upon me." And I believe that as we place our trust in God, the Lord will see us through. The woman with the hemorrhage problem, beloved in the Lord, she put her faith in Christ amidst so much obstacles. She chose to place her faith in Christ. She pushed through those obstacles, knowing and bearing in mind, she told herself, if only I can touch the hem of his garment, I will be well. May God help us, beloved, in the Lord, to have faith such as the woman with a hemorrhage problem. Against all obstacles that may stand in your way, may your faith react. May your faith arise and believe in the deliverance of your God, because your God is your ever-present help, even in life. When Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego were put on trial for their faith, beloved, in the Lord, they did not shudder back, beloved, in the Lord. They put their trust in the name of the Lord, and we know the outcome, that they were never consumed by the fire. Instead, right in the midst of the fire, there was a fourth person that stood with them. When you choose to put your trust in the name of the Lord, it does not matter the fire around you, because Christ Jesus, beloved in the Lord, will always be with us in the fire and will see us through even to the very end. Glory be unto God. Remember, there is always vindication for your confidence in your God. There will always be vindication. The Lord will always come through for your life. He will never put you to shame. He will always see you through even to the very end. And glory be unto God. Beloved in the Lord, even as I'm coming to a close, when you look at your life, there are times that the Lord, there are times that you may be going through as so many storms within your life. So many storms. But I pray that may the Lord calm those storms in your life. What storms are you facing in your life? What challenges are you facing? Besides this COVID that we are facing, beloved in the Lord, the message is clear for today. May we put our trust in the Lord. May we count on the presence of the Lord with us. The very fact that God is with us, that he is going to see us through definitely. He will not leave us to rot. He will not leave us to be consumed by this COVID-19 that is before us. The Lord, beloved in the Lord, he is going to see us through, even as his children. All that the Lord calls upon us, O children of God, is that we put our faith in him. For the Bible says, the just shall live by faith. The Lord that we say, friends, is able to calm down whatsoever storm that may blow our way. Beloved in the Lord, today's message, beloved in the Lord, is imploring us to have faith in our God. Have faith in God. Believe that God is with you, O child of God, that he is right by your side. Even though you may not see his footprints in your life, the Lord is with you. Sometimes we tend to put our trust in friends and parents and systems, but sometimes there will come a time when some of these things we put our trust in will let us down. And the Bible says, a mother may abandon her young, but the Lord will never abandon you. And so whatever circumstance you're in, be assured that your God is Emmanuel. He is God with us. He is a friend that sticks far much closer than a brother, sticks far much closer than a sister. The Lord, O child of God, is with you. He will not leave you nor forsake you. He will not abandon you in your hour or in your time of need. When friends abandon you, he will not abandon you. He'll be there with you. When you lose your job, he will be right next to you, even when you have lost your job. When you feel ill, and you fall ill, and you are sick, know that even in those times, in those difficult times, the Lord is with you. So right now, there are people around the world that have fallen a victim to COVID-19. And some of them, don't get it wrong, some of them are men of faith. They are believers, but they have fallen prey. Victim. Not that there's anything wrong with their faith, beloved in the Lord. But one thing that I know is that even when such of our brethren have fallen victim to COVID-19, one thing I know is that the prayers of the Lord is with them. Because God is not like man who changes. Man will be with you today, tomorrow they'll abandon you. But even as our friends may struggle with COVID-19, even as our friends may be have contracted the virus, even in such situations, friends, we dare not lose hope. We still remain trusting. We still remain hopeful, even in the name of the Lord. I don't know whatever your challenge might be, O child of God. Maybe your marriage is not well. Maybe your children have become so rebellious and you are worried. Maybe you've lost that job and you don't know how you sustain yourself and so forth. I encourage you, O child of God. The Lord has not forsaken you. The Lord is with you. The Lord will surely see you through. If he's able to take care of the birds of the air, and if he's able to take care of the wild beasts in the world, will he fail to take care of you, O child of God? You whom he made and created in his own image, you who has accepted him as your Lord and personal Savior, will he abandon you, O child of God? Surely not. The Lord, O child of God, is with you. Whatever situation, friends, that we are in, let's put our trust in the name of the Lord. Beloved in the Lord, this is the word of the Lord. I submit to you. May God be praised and may God be glorified because of his word that comes to instruct us, to teach us, and to remind us of God's promises and the words of encouragement upon our lives. To him and him alone be all glory, honor, and praise to Christ Jesus, our Lord and Savior. And all God's children say, amen. And amen. Let's turn to God in prayer. Heavenly Father, we continue, Lord, to thank you, to praise you, and to glorify your name. Thank you, Lord, for speaking unto us. We now, Jehovah God, want to pray for your congregation, even St. Columbus. We pray, Jehovah God, for your flock. We want to remember those that are not feeling well. We continue, Lord, to pray for Elder Mbewe. We continue to pray for your healing over his life. We thank you that he's feeling much better. We continue to pray for Mr. Mkanda. Lord, remember your manservant. We pray that complete your healing over his life in the name of Jesus Christ. We continue to pray for Mr. David Cocker. We pray, Lord, may you continue to touch him. Continue to complete your healing upon his life in Jesus' name. We continue, Jehovah God, to pray for Lucy Lilly. Lord, remember your maidservant. Continue to touch her, Lord, in Jesus' name. We continue to pray for Kelly. Lord, remember her, Lord, even as she looks up to you. We pray, God, that may you be her source of strength, especially in this time. We pray that complete your healing even over her life in Jesus' name. There could be others, Lord, whom we may not mention by name, but you commit them all into your hands for your healing touch over their lives. We pray for those that have bereaved. We remember to pray for Mrs. Chiumia, who has lost her uncle. We pray, God, for comfort over her life and her family in the name of Jesus Christ. We continue to pray for Mrs. Gumbo, who has also lost her uncle, oh God. We pray, Father, that, Lord, may you comfort her and comfort the rest of the family. We also pray for those that you may not mention by name, that, God, may your spirit of comfort visit our brethren in Jesus' name. We continue to pray for the government. We continue to pray for the president. We continue to pray for the cabinet and the opposition leaders. Lord, remember our leaders even as we lift them up and as we continue to pray for them. Lord, may they draw wisdom from you even in the governance of this country in the name of Jesus Christ. We continue to pray for COVID pandemic. We continue to pray for your intervention. We continue to pray that, God, may you help us by your grace in your wisdom to keep down this disease in the name of Jesus Christ. We thank you, Lord, that your ears are ever attentive to the prayers of the righteous. And so we know that, God, you've heard our prayers, for we pray of all these things in the name of the Father and the Holy Spirit. And all God's children said, amen and amen. Glory be unto God. Beloved in the Lord, we continue with the worship of the Lord. Thank you for taking time just to reflect with me even on God's word. Let's continue with the word with the service. Glory be unto our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
We give God all the glory for the powerful sermon. We are so grateful, Reverend, that the Lord was able to use you in a mighty way.
Glory be unto God.
Amen. Glory indeed, God. Our God is ever present. He will never leave us nor forsake us. Let's believe that word. Amen. Thank you.
Amen. Thank you so much, Patricia, for those catchy words.
You're welcome.
God the glory. Friends, we are now coming to the end of our worship service, and as we end our service, we'll sing together the closing hymn. Patricia, what closing hymn have you prepared for us?
We are singing hymn number 55 from the GHS. Because he lives, I can face tomorrow.
Amen and amen. Surely because Christ lives, we can face tomorrow. Glory be unto God.
Amen.
Amen.
Our closing hymn is hymn number 55 from the GHS. God sent his son, they called him Jesus. He came to love, heal and forgive. He lived and died to buy my pardon. An empty grave is there to prove my Savior lives. Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fear is gone. Because I know, yes, I know he holds the future. And life is worth the living just because he lives. How sweet to hold a newborn baby and feel the pride and joy he gives. But greater still, there come assurance, this child can face uncertain days because he lives. Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fear is gone. Because I know, yes, I know he holds the future. And life is worth the living just because he lives. And then one day, I'll cross the river, I'll fight life's fire, no war with pain. And then as death gives way to victory, I'll see the light of glory and I'll know he lives. Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fear is gone. Because I know, yes, I know he holds the future. And life is worth the living just because he lives. Stay blessed.
Glory be unto God for that lovely hymn to the glory of God.
Amen. We thank God.
Surely because he lives,
we can face tomorrow.
Amen. Mm-hmm. And it resonates very well with our message for today.
Amen.
Christ, our ever-present help in all circumstances.
Mm.
And the very fact that Christ lives and that he's ever with us, we can be bold and confident despite whatever we are going through. that we will see tomorrow.
Amen.
And everything's going to be all right.
Amen.
Amen and amen. Thank you so much, Patricia.
You're welcome.
Okay, any last words?
I wish you all a lovely week. May God be with you all. You are always in our thoughts and in our prayers. Amen.
Amen. Now let us say the prayer for Africa together, even as we end the service. God bless Africa. Guide her people. Guide her leaders and give her peace. Now receive the blessings of the Lord. May the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the sweet love of God the Father, and the wonderful fellowship of the Holy Spirit, may they forever dwell and abide with each and every one of us, from now and forevermore. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
And amen.
Glory be unto God. Have a lovely week ahead of you, and God bless you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
You are here, moving in our midst. I worship you. I worship you. You are here, working in this place. I worship you. I worship you.